So I'm a huge fan of Black Orchid Eau de Parfum. And when I came across the discontinued Eau de Toilette and at the price I got it for, I could not pass it up. So let's go ahead and do an unboxing and first impression of this flanker. Hey, what's going on guys? Hunter here and welcome back to my channel. And if you are new, what I do is I make fragrance related content. So if you love fragrances, go ahead and smash the subscribe button down below. But that's right guys, like I said, I'm a huge fan of the original Black Orchid that was launched back in 2016. If you didn't know, that actually was Tom Ford's first creation under his Tom Ford brand. Now the Eau de Toilette was launched in 2015 and has recently been discontinued and is very hard to find now. And I have heard that a lot of people prefer the EDT over the EDP, so we'll find out how this one actually stacks up to the original and if it still has obviously that Black Orchid DNA. Now, let's go ahead and look at the packaging really quick of this one. Of course, instead of coming in the gold box like the original EDP comes in, it is in all black right there with the black label on the front. This is an Eau de Toilette concentration, like I said, and I did get in the 50 mil since I do collect all my Tom Fords in the 50 mil size. On the top, you do have TF in gold. On the back, just some ingredients per usual. And then on the bottom, you do have your batch code and barcode to authenticate your product and see when it was produced. Now, my batch code for this, I believe it was A39. Now, I did look that batch up. This is actually a three-year-old batch. It was launched, or this batch was made in 2019. So it is 3 years old now. And that might've been when it got discontinued. I think it might've been around 2019, 2020, something like that. So let's go ahead and open up this cellophane here. Now they do obviously have the EDT, which is this one. They have the EDP, which is the original. And they just came out with a parfum recently, which I do not own, but now after owning this one, I would love to own pretty much them all. And then they had the purple bottle, and which is Velvet Orchid. And I'm not sure if that one's still being created or not. I haven't seen it in a while, so I'm not 100% sure if that one was discontinued either. And this cellophane, let's see, just give me a hard time here. I think we got it. All right. Now, I did actually find this, guys. Believe this or not, I actually got this bottle for $55. Brand new, as you guys saw, 55 bucks. I was like, that's a no-brainer. I think this did retail for $110, so a little bit less than the Eau de Parfum, which is $140. At the time of this recording, even though Tom Ford's are always raising their pricing every year, their private blends are getting outrageous as well. So let's go ahead. Oh man, this has got to be one of the most gothic, dark bottles I've ever seen. Take a look at that, guys. Completely matte black everything with the nice black label right there in the gold lettering. So I think, it might've leaked a little bit. That's not good. Yeah, I do see a little bit of leakage. Okay, so we're gonna look at that a little bit closer here in a minute, but the Eau de Parfum does come in obviously this shiny see-through black. This is completely matte black and I think it looks great. So on the bottom, of course, your sticker with your information and batch code down there as well. And then we have the cap, obviously your original Black Orchid cap. And yeah, guys, it did leak a little bit. Can you see that on camera? All the way around. Hold on 1 second. I'm gonna grab me a paper towel and wipe that down first. All right, sorry about that. I am back, guys. I had to pretty much wipe it down a little bit because as you saw, it did leak quite a bit, especially around the Tom Ford kind of string. It's kind of wet in there. I hope it didn't leak that much because it doesn't look like it really went down the bottle or anything like that, just around the atomizer right there. I have had bottles leak before from like shipping, stuff like that. And after they settle and you put them in your collection, they stop leaking. So hopefully that's the case with Black Orchid Eau de Toilette. So as I was saying, it is pretty much all matte black. I actually prefer this look over the EDP with that clear bottle. The only bad thing is I can't see inside to see how much juice is left and see how much actually leaked out. I just hope it was just a little bit evaporating around the atomizer somewhere from either heat change or altitude or something like that, even though I did pick this up in stores. Let's go ahead and spray this on and see if it smells very similar to the DNA on Black Orchid and what pretty much is different than with the EDP. So, okay, so I was gonna say, hopefully it sprays. There we go. Ooh, I'm expecting to maybe be like a more airy version of the Eau de Parfum because it is an EDT. Right in the opening, you do have the black orchid. You can tell this is definitely black orchid, but it is a little bit more fresh, a little bit more floral. I pick up on a lot more of that orchid note and some kind of like white floral as well. Definitely more florals in the opening compared to the original EDP. The EDP does have that offensive opening that lasts a very, very long time that does offend a lot of people. And people are kind of persuaded away from black orchid EDP because of that opening, because you have that dark earthy truffle note. Wait, whoa, okay. I am picking up on that earthy truffle note still, which I love. I love the opening of the EDP because of that truffle. If you don't know what truffle is, it's actually a mushroom that's grown that grows under the ground in the dirt, obviously. It's not like truffle chocolate, nothing like that. It is coming across very dirty. I'm really liking this one, guys. It's almost like just a little bit more floral version of the Black Orchid EDP, in my opinion. You still get the truffle. I am still getting a nice green earthy patchouli in there. It may be a little bit more bright. I think I'm getting like a bergamot in the top. So yeah, bergamot, I'm getting orchid, some kind of white florals in there, maybe jasmine, maybe a rose, maybe tuberose, maybe, which I don't really pick up on in the original is maybe the same florals I'm getting in here. I don't know if it has the same exact note breakdown as the EDP or if anything is different at all. But yeah, just a little bit more floral heavy in the opening, I would say. It's hard to tell since the original Black Orchid was launched as a feminine fragrance, but was recently changed to be a unisex, which I think they did a very good job with that because that does come across very unisex to me. It's nothing feminine, or at least mostly feminine about that fragrance. It is right down the middle, both a guy and a woman can pull that one off. But with the EDT here, since it's coming across much more kind of transparent, much more airy than the EDPs, which is very, very dense, very complex. And this one had a little bit more floral touches to it. This one might lean a little bit more feminine than the EDP in my opinion, but don't get me wrong, this is still Black Orchid to the core. You still, like I said, get that dark truffle note that is very dirty, very earthy smelling, almost slightly like animalic I'm getting with this fragrance. You get the patchouli, which is also earthy. So this is a very earthy, very floral heavy fragrance. So with the original EDP, that has got to be one of the most complex fragrances in my entire collection. It just has so many notes in it and it never smells the same for every minute. It always changes on my skin at least. I can tell this one is still complex. Well, yeah, it's changing a little bit and this stuff is good. Even the truffle is coming across a little bit more. So maybe just in that opening, you're gonna get that burst of floral notes. And I don't know if I'm getting that dark chocolate that was found in the original EDP either. I'm not really getting any kind of chocolate vibe in this fragrance. Like I said, just mostly earthy and floral. Nothing really chocolatey about it. So what I would pretty much say, since it's obviously is coming across a little bit more vibrant in my opinion, for me at least, since I own both the EDP and now EDT in my collection, I would pretty much stick with the EDT for maybe like the warmer evenings, maybe like spring, summer evening time, because it still is a dark fragrance. It's nothing about this screams summertime. Nothing screams like warm weather, but this does work in the evening, in my opinion, once it's like cooled down maybe 60, 70 degrees or so in like the spring and summer. If you're going on like a date and stuff, I would definitely wear this one for that occasion and keep my EDP just for the fall and winter time, because that stuff is a little bit more dense. It's a little bit more full bodied, in my opinion, compared to the EDT. But man, this is good too. Definitely Black Orchid. If I were to smell this in the air, I would be like, yeah, that's Black Orchid. Maybe just going through its phases that it does, or just the person's skin chemistry. It makes it change a little bit because it is slightly different than the EDP. Would I say it's redundant to own both? Honestly, it might be redundant to own both. If you're looking for a more floral heavy version of the EDP and you don't like the dark kind of dirty earthy tones of that version, definitely check out the EDT. I don't know if you should still be able to find this at semi good prices, even though it has been discontinued for maybe a year or so, maybe 2 years. Just look around because this is very good, especially if you're a woman and you don't like that kind of opening of, or even the dry down of the EDP and you want that more orchid touch, you want more of the like floral vibe in their fragrance, the EDT might be for you. And I think I heard women were actually mad that they discontinued this because they actually preferred the EDT over the EDP. This was like the Black Orchid for them, so to say. So definitely look out for a bottle of this stuff. Even though for me, it is still a unisex fragrance because it does have the truffle, it does have the patchouli, maybe a little bit smokiness as well as it dries down. This might be like incense. All in all, a fantastic fragrance. I'm a sucker for Black Orchid. If you watch my top Tom Ford's, my collection, which I had 14, and I just recorded that video literally like 2 days ago, and now I got this one. So this is my 15th Tom Ford in my collection. I would have probably ranked this alongside the EDP, probably just put them together because they do smell pretty much very, very close, just subtle differences. But man, I love Black Orchid. I'm so glad to finally have obviously another one. I cannot wait to get the Parfum to my collection because that's also a very dark, slightly different. Actually, that one's probably more different than the EDP than this one is different than the EDP, to be honest. This is much more similar to the EDP than the Parfum is. I think there's booziness to the Parfum, leathery aspect, stuff like that. So it is a little bit different. So for the EDT, it is unisex. I'm absolutely gonna rock this one. It smells so good, especially with my skin chemistry with Black Orchid. It's just top notch. And the performance of the EDP is so good. I cannot wait to see how this one performs. Now, from my experiences, Eau De Toilette actually project more than Eau De Parfums, even though Eau De Parfums last longer than Eau De Toilette. So if you're looking for like more projection, definitely check out the EDT. If you're looking for more of the Eau De, like longevity aspects, EDPs are usually the way to go because what makes a fragrance project is actually the alcohol concentration. And obviously with EDTs, you have more alcohol, less oil. So that's pretty much the reason why. So that's pretty much gonna wrap up my first impression and unboxing of Black Orchid Eau De Toilette, this discontinued gem here. So happy to have a part of my Tom Ford collection. It'll be right at home in my collection here. So leave a like on the video if you did enjoy it. Let me know down below if you've tried the EDT or how do you feel about Black Orchid in general, and if you actually rock it yourselves. I'm definitely curious. But as usual, subscribe if you guys haven't already, and I'll catch all you guys in the next upload. Take care, everybody.